Alessa, what's the weather?
With a high of 84 degrees and a low of 74 degrees.
Sir?
Jeremiah, what the weather, would they come out on the weather?
What is it to you?
I don't know, what would they say?
There's a chance for strong winds. What's the weather?
Did you know that crickets can help you tell the temperature? Count the number of cricket chirps you hear outside in 14 seconds. Get the temperature in Fahrenheit. It's 79 degrees Fahrenheit with thunderstorms. Today's forecast calls for more of the same, with a high of 84 degrees.
Follow. My bad. Excuse me. How bad does it look like?
It's cloudy out there. Currently, in New Orleans, Louisiana, it's 88 degrees Fahrenheit with mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, you can expect just a few clouds in the sky with a low of 79 degrees.
Maybe a couple of showers for our North Shore spots. And almost nothing south of the lake. And now it looks like we're probably going to see this rain eventually cross the lake into south shore locations. In fact, it's very close to La Place at this time. Just updating you on the status of the line. Still officially have these warnings going, I believe, until 6. It is 6 for the tornado warning, and I believe it's 6 for the severe warning for the rest of St. Tammany and Washington parishes as well. And that would be, of course, for not only possible rotation, but more so for high wind gusts or the large hail potential with the line of storms. Moving farther south, you can see it's arrived now at Lake Maurepas, almost completely covering the lake. It's at Lutcher, it's farther south, almost toward Napoleonville, almost at and some of our other locations are going to be seeing this move in shortly as well. In Kenwood, we have a photo coming in. It is a tree that has been snapped, and this is from the Kansas. I believe officially under the tornado warning, but you can see the kind of high wind gust action that was all along the line, north and even south, where our severe warning ends right at the southern tip of Tangipahoa Parish. But on the northern end, certainly seeing some of this damage as far as, you know, photos that we've seen so far coming in. And further south, it's been a little bit weaker, but we have also seen a bit of reports, I believe, from around Baton Rouge, even though that was on the southern edge of the line when it was first making its way toward us.
Yes, Livingston Parish, just south of I-12. We saw that.
If that happens, then there will likely be a couple of warnings issued. But for now, we're just finishing out this warning, which goes until 6 p.m. That's our tornado warning for that part of it. Goes out of effect at 6 p.m. They're going to let it expire. So the warning box is still there, but we're not really seeing a tornado potential for that particular location anymore. Really, you can see as we've turned to 6, it has now gone away. But our severe thunderstorm warning continues, and this is across Washington, St. Tammany parishes, and into Pearl River County, just about in Mississippi, although not necessarily officially included. But the line is moving to the southeast, and it has been doing so and has not been weakening all that much, especially the northern edge of this line. So very interesting to see this just charge on in and not weaken, although these systems sometimes do weaken when they reach our part of Louisiana, especially later in the day. We'll track our official or potential timing here as this line continues. We will probably see it hold together for south of the lake locations. You can see around Schriever, 6:50 or so. Maybe a little after 7 p.m. That would include the Metairie area, somewhere around 7 p.m. as well. On toward Houma, maybe around 7:30. And then potentially it could move on to our Mississippi coastal spots, although that's a ways out, so we will see whether it weakens a bit. But it would be potentially about 8:30 that we see it reach Mississippi. Here is the line again charging across Mississippi, Louisiana, and now moving right across our viewing area, just now reaching Lake Pontchartrain. So
Alessa, what's the weather?
Did you know that crickets can help you tell the temperature? Count the number of cricket chirps you hear outside in 14 seconds, then add 40 to get the temperature in Fahrenheit. The current weather is 84 degrees Fahrenheit with partly sunny skies. Tonight's forecast has mostly clear skies, with a low of 82 degrees.
Alessa, is there a severe thunderstorm?
For Gulfport, Mississippi, there are currently no weather alerts.
Alessa, what's the weather? Alessa, what's the weather?
The current weather is 84 degrees.
Alessa, what's the weather?
The current weather is 84 degrees Fahrenheit with partly sunny skies. Tonight, you can look for mostly clear skies, with a low of 82 degrees.
Alessa, what's the weather?
The current weather is 84 degrees Fahrenheit with partly sunny skies. Tonight, you can expect mostly clear skies, with a low of 82 degrees.
Alessa, is there a severe thunderstorm?
For Gulfport, Mississippi, there are currently no weather alerts.
Is there a glitch or something? Because I keep going back and forth with the weather, with the warning. Alessa, what's the weather?
Let's take a trip to the skies and see what's happening, weather-wise. The current weather is 84 degrees Fahrenheit with partly sunny skies. Tonight, you can expect mostly clear skies, with a low of 82 degrees.
Alessa, what's the weather?
This weather always makes me want to dance, 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 dance. Current weather is 84 degrees Fahrenheit with partly sunny skies. Tonight's forecast has mostly clear skies, with a low of 82 degrees.
Alessa, what's the weather? Alessa, what's the weather? Alessa, what's the weather in Bay St. Louis?
Or is that a dog? Either way, it's cloudy out there. Right now in Bay 88 degrees Fahrenheit with mostly cloudy skies. Tonight's forecast has some clouds with a chance of thunder showers with a low of 82 degrees.
Across a road up there, it was submitted by a WWL viewer. We do have crews who are heading out to assess the damage across the area. Of course, we heard reports that there were tornado warnings. The National Weather Service saying that there was the possibility that there may have been a spotted tornado out there. So we'll have to wait and see what those damage reports are.
Right, and we should get more information from them hopefully at some point. But interesting to see the at least pictures coming in.
Yes,
and also to see some of those wind speeds and estimated wind gusts at 60 plus miles per hour. Looking at our line, which has charged across our north of the lake spots and is just for some south of Lake Pontchartrain locations. There it is. You can see it weakening a little bit, but it really ramped up as it headed right towards Tangipahoa Parish. We had a big, long tornado warning for Ames, also for the Folsom area. And now, thankfully, things are a little quieter. However, there is a new severe thunderstorm warning, which includes just the area where the line has not made it yet, north of Lake Pontchartrain and into Mississippi. And we will be watching that one until about 7 or a little bit after, potentially, the farther to the east it goes. This is one of these complexes that we've actually seen skirting our area, weakening before it gets to us, or just completely staying north of our area. But these have been a pretty common thing that we've seen in the past week plus across all the central part of the U.S. And by the time they reach us, they've either kind of veered off to the north or stayed to the north or weakened. But not tonight. We had this line of storms moving in. If you're curious about the timing heading into the rest of this evening, here is the tentative timeline. It's been moving the entire line as a whole about 25 or 30 miles per hour to the southeast. And you can see that puts it at New Orleans a bit after 7 p.m. potentially, on toward Houma maybe 7:30, and other southeast Mississippi in the 8 p.m. hour. So we are seeing some indications that it's weakening. Hopefully it continues to do that, but north of Lake Pontchartrain, there could still easily be some high wind gusts. And we'll keep watching just in case there are a few more of those rotating segments that we saw earlier. Look at this ominous look across New Orleans as we see this line approach from the northwest. 86 degrees right now. Our highs today were close to 90. Big drop off in temperatures.
Alyssa, what's the weather?
Let's check the weather. It will help us pick out a snappy outfit to match with today's forecast. The current weather is 84 degrees Fahrenheit with rain. Tonight, you can expect some clouds with a chance of thunder showers with a low of 82 degrees.
Alyssa, what's the weather?
The current weather is 84 degrees Fahrenheit with rain. Tonight's forecast has some clouds with a chance of thunder showers, with a low of 82 degrees.
Alyssa, what's the weather?
To see, but you can see some spots at least where there is some rotation, and actually just see it like this tornado warning possibly just come to an end. Let me put back on. Radar. And yes, let me just confirm really quick. The National Weather Service. Uh-huh. ended it. Still an active severe thunderstorm. There have been several marine warnings, of course. Over Lake Pontchartrain recorded. As Devin said, we've been seeing here and there some pictures of trees down in different spots, just sort of all over different parts of the world. It doesn't matter. They don't supposed to be folk rain. Supposed to have shoes on. They are house shoes. The key word, house shoes. They are not to be ran in and not to be doggone doing what you're doing. If you're going to walk in them outside, you need to walk with them. Walk in them. Put some drinks in the refrigerator. You need to walk in them, not run in them.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
So I can understand, you know, if, you know, some people may think it's just kind of a regular thunderstorm. It might be that for your area, but there have been high wind gusts, lots of power outages north of the lake. And we're seeing a spot of really heavy rain developing now over Lake Salvador near Jean Lafitte. So some of the West Bank and much of New Orleans now getting in on heavy rain. So yeah, tracking these strong storms as they moved in and really did not let up as they crossed our area. Looking at velocity, by the way, let's check out that area in Hancock County once again. And it's getting a little bit more difficult to see, but you can see some spots at least where there is some rotation. And actually, did I just see?
Ma'am.
On that, we're watching storms right now on the radar. We got severe thunderstorm warnings now in effect for Pearl River County and Hancock County, and now western portions of Harrison County. That goes until 7 o'clock, and it's for this cluster of storms and has been racing across central Louisiana, now making its way into South Mississippi. It's moving at about 45 miles per hour, and that severe thunderstorm warning means that some isolated damaging wind gusts could approach 60 miles per hour at times in some of the stronger portions of the storm. So putting a storm track on this is pretty much on the doorstep of Pearl River and Hancock counties, but it will most likely begin to reach Stone and Harrison counties after about 7 o'clock, and most likely making its way into George and Jackson County after about 8 o'clock this evening. So this complex of storms began all the way in southeastern Oklahoma this morning, and it has made its way across the state of Louisiana, now moving into Mississippi. And that's just the kind of pattern we've been in the last couple of days. These complexes of storms developing to our north and to our west, and they're riding through the jet stream and making their way down towards the Gulf Coast. Storm Prediction Center has highlighted all of South Mississippi in a marginal risk for severe storms, slight risk just to our north and west. But again, the risk for severe weather exists in all risk categories. It's just the chances of seeing it increases as you go up from marginal to high on that scale. So certainly the risk is there over the next couple of hours. Here's what it looks like on Futurecast. As we advance to about 7 o'clock, Futurecast showing that cluster of storms making its way through South Mississippi. Maybe some subtle hints of weakening. Earlier, this line of storms was prompting tornado warnings in Louisiana. So hopefully, as it continues to push off towards the east and encounters some slightly more stable air, hopefully that will help it weaken over the next couple of hours or so. But certainly could produce some strong gusty winds. We're also starting to see some storms develop ahead of it, and we're actually seeing some of those storm clouds on the Hancock Whitney Bank Tower Cam in Gulfport. 84 degrees, we got a south wind at 7 miles per hour. Tomorrow, we could do this all over again. It could start off with temperatures in the 80s, maybe a stray shower or two. But as we go into the afternoon, we're warming up into the upper 80s to low 90s, heat index values in the 100 to 105 degree range. And it's possible we could see another round of showers and thunderstorms approach from the north and west. Quick update on the tropics. Of course, hurricane season officially began this week, and we're also kind of keeping an eye on an area in the Caribbean as we go into late this week, early next week. Nothing has developed yet, but we're just keeping an eye on the potential for some unsettled weather to develop with a broad area of low pressure that is known as the Central American Gyre. It's essentially an area of low pressure that develops across Central America and can sometimes lead to tropical development. There are some hints that some of that moisture could make its way towards the Gulf as we head into next week, but it's way too early to say exactly when and where and who could see impacts on how organized this may be, but just something we're keeping an eye on. 7-day forecast, it looks like this again as we go into the Wednesday, Thursday time frame. Hit and miss storms possible, hot and humid.
Well, that's what they've been talking about, is that. And that's what I was preparing for. Alessa, what's the weather? Mm-hmm. Okay. Where? Alessa, what's the weather?
Currently, in Gulfport, it's 76 degrees Fahrenheit with thunderstorms. Tonight, you can expect some clouds with a chance of thunder showers, with a low of 76 degrees. Also, there's a severe thunderstorm warning in effect until Tuesday, June 4th, 8 p.m.
No, I think... There were strong winds. I saw it. How did you just miss them? There was strong winds. I saw it though.
Storm blowing through South Mississippi quickly earlier tonight. The high winds also lifting this trampoline off the ground in Long Beach. Thanks for joining us tonight. WOLX News Now 10.
Yeah, the worst of the storm seems to be over here in South Mississippi, but what can we expect heading into the rest of the week?
Yeah, well, those storms, they came in and they have a lot of wind, and that's what we're concerned about as that line of storms rolled down through. Even had some reports of some wind damage around Picayune. Check out this photo sent in by Shannon Crosby on the WOLX weather app. You can see that tree laying across the road there. That is also where we had that tornado warning that prompted those storms roll through.